in to some of the celebrations there. That's the details.
God is so good. And the girls worked hard alongside the board of management and the PTA in general.
What more details can you tell us about how the girls performed? How the girls performed?
Extremely well. We are leading the country.
You're leading the country. Alliance Girls is...
A's, while the next school has got 10 A's. It's so great.
16 A's and 10 A's.
Yeah. I mean, 16 A's for the school.
Will that be including Alliance Boys or just Alliance Girls?
All the schools.
Yes, Alliance Girls. Yes, yes. Chairman, this is the chairman of the board. The chairman of the board.
Yeah. Chairman, how are you feeling about the great news? 16 A's, that is something big.
Very well. That is great. And we are very happy that the teachers have worked so hard together with the students. This is, we are very proud of the school. And we will support them, we will continue to support them and sustain that performance in the years to come.
Matiang'i has said Alliance, and I quote, has maintained consistency. It's one of the top schools that we've seen throughout the year. And I'm sure the teachers have also been working very hard. And what would you say when it comes to Matiang'i's disciplinary to make sure that our students are deserving the best quality education?
Perfect. In our school, we walk in the light. We don't believe in shortcuts. And therefore, we want to thank Dr. Matiang'i for really coming and making sure things are done in the right way.
Yeah.
Yes.
It is the best thing that could happen to the education system, because now the A's are A's and the performance is real. So it is the best thing. I mean, that's what should be kept and perpetuated. Yes.
We support the reforms that Dr. Matiang'i has done.
Yes.
They have really gotten the education system in this country back on track. As she says, an A is an A.
Yeah.
A B plus is a B plus.
Yes.
And it is not poisoned, it is not adulterated, it's a clean
A.
There's
no virus.
So we are very happy with that. And we congratulate Dr. Matiang'i and his team in the ministry and the TSE and everywhere, those who have worked so hard to make sure that we get back on track.
Speaking of putting measures into place to make sure that cheating is being curbed in our education system, to make sure the students are receiving the best quality education, a few lecturers and principals, really, about 40 of them, have been saying that they will be taken into questioning over the issue of cheating. What are your thoughts on this, and how can we improve this, the relationship with our teachers to make sure that we are giving our students excellent performance and not encouraging cheating?
You see, teachers are trained to teach, and therefore they will only examine what they have taught. So a teacher at the end of the day should be asking, has learning taken place? Therefore, no room for cheating. As Alliance Girls, we don't believe in cheating, because we work hard, we wake up in the morning, we pray God. At the end of the day, we do our work well. Yes.
Yeah, something. It's also important to note that as teachers and lecturers, I have been a teacher at high school, I've been lecturing at the university, though now I'm out of it, I'm in parliament. But a teacher needs to give the child the confidence. Once you have learned, you should not panic. Go ahead and apply the knowledge. I think that is what is most important in making sure that our children get the grades that they really deserve.
Okay. Would you like to add to that?
Yeah, I just wanted to say that will send a warning to teachers now. They'll be knowing that if they do it, if they encourage cheating, they'll be found out and they'll be punished. And therefore, it is a way of letting them know, now, go teach, don't cheat.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. The girls have performed better than the boys. What are your thoughts on this, and how can we continue to make sure that our boys are not being left behind?
Well, no comment. No comment.
But you have Alliance Boys. You have Alliance Boys on the other side.
Okay, what I would say is that for a long time, we took it for granted that boys should always perform very well. Then there was a paradigm shift where most parents started focusing on girl child. So time has come now, we treat both girls and boys in the same way so that there is no overemphasis on girl child and forget boys who are of equal number. So I would just say that it's a question of parents, schools, the systems, wherever they are. We stop not necessarily overemphasizing on girls, but we treat the two as children who require same level of performance. Because we have overemphasized girls. Yes.
All right. I think bottom line, boy or girls, I just think you need to have God. You know, as long as the God is institutionalized in any school, irrespective of whether you're in a boys' school or in a girls' school, once the children know that with God everything is possible, I think we're good to go.
All right, Michelle, as we've had 16 A's from here in Alliance, the top highest performing school here at Alliance Girls in the entire country, and a lot of celebration coming from both the teachers, the principals, the board of directors, as you can see. So back to you, Michelle.
All right, many thanks. A lot of excitement there.